our today's topic will be mixtures and allegations, out of which we will not be dealing with allegations, we'll only be dealing with mixtures. Okay, if there are any new students, welcome to Learn Online, guys. And as you know, this course is our Wipro free batch, wherein we are training students for, initially we had many degree students as well who were training for WILP. This is for national level talent hunt, that is Wipro NLTH. Yes, welcome one and all. And in time to come, we'll also be having a AMCAT batch, wherein you guys can also join in who are engineers and from various fields. Detailed description about that will be provided to in time to come. My name is Praveen Jadhav, if you don't know. Okay, let's get started with the session. Welcome one and all. Okay, now to start with it, I will take up an example wherein there is a class 1 which consists of 10 students. Okay, there is class N2 which consists of 20 students. Okay, the average weight of the class 1 is given as to be 20 kgs, and that of class 2 is given as to be 35 kgs. Now, if I ask you, what is the combined average of this class? Let me denote it as A dash. If I ask you this, a few of you might be going with directly adding this and dividing it by 2, which is exactly wrong. Why is it wrong? Because if you see, the number of students in each class are different. So how to deal with it? Look, when I say the average weight of class 1 is 20 kgs, what do I mean? That every person in this class, that is consisting of 10 people, everyone weighs how much? 10. So, sorry, 20. So, how much is the weight, the overall weight of this class? How do I calculate the overall weight of this class? I have to multiply this 20 with a 10, which gives me a 200. Yes, now the overall weight of this class here, that gives me, that is calculated by multiplying 35 with 20, that gives me a 700. Yes, dividing it with the total strength, that is N1 plus N2, that is 20, that gives me how much? 30 here. So what will be it? 900 upon 30, that is the average weight is how much? 30 kgs. Now, if you observe carefully, what did I do to arrive at this 200? Which is my combined average. How did I arrive at it? Help me with that. What did I do? I multiplied the number of students in class 1 into their average weight and added it with the number of students in class 2 into their average weight, divided by N1 plus N2, that is the strengths of class 1 and class 2. Now, if I take this N1 and N2 onto the other side, what will that give me? That gives me A dash, and I'm directly multiplying it, guys, this time. A dash N1 plus A dash N2 is equals to A1 N1 plus A2 N2. Okay? On taking my N1 terms on one side, what does that give me? N1. I'm also taking N1 common out of this, so that gives me A dash minus A1 is equals to N2 common onto this side, that gives me how much? That gives me A2 minus this thing here, so minus A dash. So what will be my N1 upon N2? N1 upon N2 will be equals to A2 minus A dash divided by A dash minus A1. A dash minus A1. If you have difficulty remembering this formula, just focus. What is this? What is this A2? A2 is nothing but the greater average minus, that is combined average divided by combined average minus the smaller average, will give me the ratio of, or N1 upon N2. Okay? Taking the same question ahead. Now, the question might be something like this. A class consists of, the average weight of students in a class is 20 kg, okay, and that of class 2 and average weight of another class is 35 kgs. If the combined average of both the classes is 30 kgs, in what ratio must students in this class and this class be mixed? In what ratio they should be? So how do we go about this? Just check it out. Now, here, 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 here. Now, 20 minus 30. When I am doing this, I am calculating the difference but not subtracting it. What do I mean by difference? Difference means I am going to reduce the smaller number from the greater number. So 30 minus 20 gives me how much here? 10 kgs. So 35 minus 30 gives me how much? 5. So what is the ratio in which class 1 and class 2 are to be supposed to be divided to have the combined average of 30? They should be divided in the ratio 1:2. 1:2. Yes. Were you able to understand? Yes. Now, if I move ahead and I tell you that the total strength of the class, if the total strength of the class is 30 for the same question that I'm dealing. If I tell you that the total strength of the class is 30 and I ask you to find out the class strength of class 1, how will you go about it? This is, what is the ratio that we have got? We have got the ratio n1:n2. So what am I asking? The strength of the class 1. So how will I go about it? Class 1 consists of, what will be it? One part out of total of 3 parts. One part out of 2 plus 1, 3 parts of 30 will belong to what? Class 1. So how much will that be? 10. So look, 10. What is exactly that I've taken here? Yes. Now, moving ahead. If n1 is 10, n2 will be the remaining part, that is 20. Do I get the same ratio on applying the formula that I've derived here? Yes. Check it out. What is it? N1 upon N2 is equals to greater average. Greater average is 35 kg minus combined average, that is 30 kg divided by combined average, that is 30 minus lower average, that is 20. That gives me how much? 5 upon 10, which is again 1:2. Which is again 1:2. The same question will be asked in mixtures. How? Look, there is rice one which costs 20 rupees per kg. 20 rupees per kg. Rice two costs 35 rupees per kg. 35 rupees per kg. In what ratio should rice one and rice two be mixed such that the combined mixture cost 30 rupees per kg. 30 rupees per kg. What did I say? We should go with the difference here. What is the difference here? 10. What is the difference here? 5. So what ratio should rice 1 and rice 2 be mixed? They must be mixed in the ratio 1:2. They must be mixed in the ratio 1:2. Yes. Are you able to understand? And if you observe carefully, I'm always comparing the similar terms. Okay. Till here, take it down and we'll start up with the questions that we have. Okay. Anybody has any doubt? Annapurna says, sir, how you took 1/3? Where did I take 1/3? Okay, ratio part. Have we dealt with ratios? No, we haven't dealt with ratios. Okay, look, observe. I'll tell you a small thing about ratios, okay? Okay. Now, let's say, there is 5 ml of spirit in a glass and 15 ml of water in that glass. What is that? 5 ml of spirit and 15 ml of water. I'll write it spirit here and this is water here. Now, this is the actual value, class. This is what? This is the actual value. When I want to go to the ratio, what do? I remove a HCF. And what is that here in this case? It is 5. On dividing with 5, I divided with the HCF. That is 5. What does that give me? That gives me a ratio of 1:3. 1:3. Now, if I ask you, if there is 30 liters of this solution, okay, what mixed solution of containing spirit and water. Now, if I ask you, how much is, okay, if there is 20 liters of this solution containing what? Spirit and water. And I ask you, what is the spirit in this water? The quantity of spirit in this total solution. Then how will you answer it? It should be one part. Spirit is how much? One part out of total of four parts. One part out of total of four parts of how many liters? 20 liters. Of 20 liters. That gives me how much? 4, 1 times, 4, 5 times. How much is it? 5 liters. 5 liters. Yes. Now, what about water? Quantity of water? Annapurna, can you help me with that? So water will be what parts? It will be three parts out of total of how many parts? 3 plus 1, 4. Three parts out of total of four parts of 20 liters will be what? Water. So how many times? 4, 5 times. 5 into 3, 15 liters. Yes, able to follow everyone with this small part on ratios? Is the class comfortable? Can we move to the next part? And before that, what is that we need to do? We need to take down whatever is there on the screen and let me know when you are done. And how do you let me know? You drop a MA in the chat box, which means mission accomplished. It says, in what ratio must a shopkeeper mix two types of rice worth rupees 50 a kg and rupees 70 a kg so that the average cost of the mixture is 65 rupees a kg? Now, look at the question. We have solved already similar question. There is rice 1, there is rice 2. Okay, I'm sorry. Okay, where do I write? Okay, I'll write it here. There is rice 1, there is rice 2. Okay, there is rice 1, there is rice 2. The price, shopkeeper makes 2 rice worth rupees 50 a kg. Where should I write 50? 50 rupees per kg, 1 rice. The second rice costs how much? Rupees 70 a kg, 70 a kg. Next, so that the average cost of the mixture, so average cost is nothing but what? My A dash or my combined average, A dash or my combined average. And where should I write it? I should write it here in between, that is 65 kg rupees per kg. Yes, 65 rupees per kg. Now what do I have to do? Calculate the difference, which is simple. 65, I get a 15 here. How much do I get here? 5 here. So in what ratio should they both be mixed? 5 ones, 5 threes. 1 is to 3. In what ratio should they be mixed? They must be mixed in the ratio 1 is to 3. Okay, anybody any doubt? Simple question, right? Let's move to the next question. Let's get back. A mixture contains 88% of sulfur. Okay, a mixture contains 88% of sulfur and another mixture contains 70% sulfur. There are two mixtures. Let me take them as M1 and M2. And the first mixture contains 88% sulfur. What is percentage of sulfur in it? 88%. Another mixture contains 70% sulfur. How much is it? 70% sulfur. In order to get 84% sulfur, in what ratio these two must be mixed? 84%, where should I write it? Quickly guys, where should I write this 84%? I should write here as the combined average. Yes, so what will be the difference here? The difference will be 88 minus 84, that gives me a 4 here, and 70 minus 84, that gives me a 14 here. Yes, so in what ratio they both must be mixed? That is nothing but 2 times and 7 times. 7 is to 2. 7 is to 2. If you observe, what am I doing here? Okay, Bhargavi, why is it 3 is to 2? They do not, just it is simple calculations. I took the difference here, which gave me a 4 here and a 14 here. Yes, 14 here. The ratio is 7 is to 2. Can we correct that, Bhargavi? Yes. Chalo. Well, let's move to the next question. Okay, if you observe here, what are we doing? First, we dealt with rupees per kg. Next, we have dealt with percentages. Now, let's have the next question. What does the next question say? In what ratio water be mixed with juice? So the two substances that I have here is water and juice. Water and juice. In what ratio water be mixed with juice costing rupees 12 per liter? Costing rupees 12 per liter. What is rupees 12 per liter, dear? What is rupees 12 per liter? 12 per liter is what? 12 per liter is my juice. Rupees 12 per liter is my juice. Next. To obtain a mixture worth rupees 8 per liter. Rupees 8 per liter is what? Rupees 8 per liter is my combined average. So what about water? I want to see answers from you. What do you think the water will be? Do not be sorry, Bhargavi. Come on. Be sportive. What do you think water will be? How many of you say you want to go with X? How many are still with your X? How many of you are still with your X? Very good. Bhargavi came up with a perfect answer there. But what about here in the Zoom? How many are still with the X? No, you cannot go with the X. Why? Water is free of cost. Whenever you see a question in mixtures and allegations upon water, you have to treat water as to be a free entity. You have to treat water as to be a free entity, and it is going to cost you how much? 0 rupees per liter. 0 rupees per liter. Now the difference here, difference will be how much? I'll get 8 here, and the difference here, difference will be how much? 4 here. What is the ratio? 1:2. What is the ratio? 1:2. In what ratio should water and juice be mixed? They must be mixed in the ratio 1:2. 1:2. Everyone able to follow? I hope you guys are able to follow. Well, let's have the next question then. If you guys are able to follow, let's have the next question. We'll quickly move to the next question. What does it say? Now, pay attention. What did we do? Rupees per kg. Next, percentage. Next, we saw that if we have water, we have to assume it has to be 0 rupees per liter. Stay corrected. Now what is that we need to do? Read the question. 400 grams of spirit solution has 30% spirit in it. 400 grams of spirit solution. Okay, spirit solution has 30% spirit in it. What is the ratio of spirit should be added? Spirit should be added to make it 80% in the solution. There is a spirit solution which contains 30% spirit in it. Okay, the spirit here is how much? 30%. Okay, what is the ratio of spirit to be added? So what should I take here? I should take spirit here. Yes, what is the ratio of spirit to be added to make spirit should be added to make it 80% in the solution. Where should I write my 80% class? Where should I write it? Combined average A dash. Yes, 80% will come here. So what about spirit? What about spirit? Now, what is spirit solution is my first question. What is spirit solution? Spirit solution is nothing but a mixture of solute and solvent. A solution is nothing but what? A mixture of solute and solvent. Now, what happens here? The spirit concentration is 30%. The water is, if it is a solution, the water is 70%. What are we adding to it? What is that we are adding to it? We are adding spirit to it. What will be the concentration of spirit within spirit? What will be the concentration of spirit within spirit? The concentration of spirit within spirit will be 100%. Why? 100% why? Because this will be a concentrated solution. Here he says it is spirit solution. But what is he adding here in the next step? If you see, in what ratio spirit should be added? The spirit will contain 100% of spirit in it. Now upon this, what is it? Next step is easy. 30 difference. How much do I get? 50 here. What is the difference here? 20 here. So in what ratio should spirit solution be mixed with what ratio the spirit should be added to make 80% of spirit solution? It should be 2:5. Yes, able to follow everyone? 2:5. What did we do? We are dealing with different types of questions that we come across in mixtures and allegations, wherein if you get a question where it says, talks about spirit solution and something, a solution and a concentrated version of it being added to it, what are you supposed to do? Whenever you see a concentrated version being added, you have to assume it has to be 100%. It is 100. You need not have to assume it. It actually is 100%. Yes? Able to follow everyone? Okay. Let's move to the next question that we have here. What is the next question? Okay. A little bit tricky here, guys. You need to be keen on your observation. What did I say? Keen on your observation. Listen to the question there. In what ratio must two kinds of sugar? There are two kinds of sugar. Can I immediately write S1 and S2 here? Okay. S1 and S2 here. Fine. Can I write S1 and S2 here? Yes. In what ratio must two kinds of sugar, rupees 1.15 and rupees 1.24 per kg be mixed? Rupees 1.15 per kg and rupees 1.24 per kg be added. 1.24 per kg be added. Mixed so that the selling price of 1.50 per kg, okay? Mix so that by selling at rupees 1.50 per kg, 25% may be gained. 25% may be gained. So now, everyone, I'll give you a brief 10-second gap. You have to tell me, where should I write 1.50? 10 seconds starts now. Should I write it in the center? If you think I should write it here in the center, then drop a C quickly. If you think I should drop it in the center, that 1.50, then quickly drop a C. Everyone should answer, guys. It doesn't take much to answer this. You just, if you think I should write it here in the center, you should drop a C there. So who says? Charan says it is average. If not, then a few of them are typing C's there. Okay, I can see that. Now, this is not C. Why? Read the question carefully. Read the question carefully. What does the question say? So that by selling it at rupees 1.50 per kg, what are you doing? Selling it at rupees 1.50 per kg. So what is given to us? The thing that is given to us, 1.50 is the selling price. Selling price that is given. Here, cost price is given. Here, cost price is given. So what should I have here as the combined average as well? Combined average part, I should have cost price. But even if then, if you wanted to eliminate it, if you check, the combined average must always fall between the two entities. Check 12, 0 and 12, the combined average is 8. 30% and 100%, combined average is 80. 50 and 70, combined average is 65. 88 and 70, combined average is 84. It should fall between them. So you could have eliminated it directly. Now, on giving thought, I found out that 1.50 is the selling price. 1.50 is selling price. 25% may be gained. When he says 25% may be gained, what does that mean? It means that he has given me profit percentage. How much is it? 25%. So when selling price is given, profit is given, how do I calculate my cost price? If you have seen our profit and loss videos, you could have found it that whenever selling price and profit are given, I calculate my CP by writing a relationship between selling price and cost price. So how do I write that? Selling price is equals to 125% profit. The profit or loss, it is made over what? The cost price. So 100% of cost price plus 25% of profit is made. Profit is made also on the cost price. 100% of cost price plus 25% of cost price. That gives me 125% of cost price. 125% of cost price. Now, using this, can I calculate my CP? Yes, I can calculate it. What is given? 1.50 equals to 125 is nothing but what? 125% is nothing but what? 125 upon 100. 25 four times will give me 100. 25 five times will give me a 125. So I'll keep the CP here the way it is. Now, can I go with 5? 5, yes. 5 threes is 15, but I need a 0.3 to get to 1.5. Yes. 4 into 0.3. 4 into 3 is 12, but I have a point, so I'll get CP has to be how much? CP has to be how much, guys? 1.2. I'll get CP has to be 1.2. Now, where should I keep this CP cost price? This is the combined average part. And after this, this question is done. This is what cost price is? Rupees 1.2 per kg. So what should I do? Difference. Difference is how much? 1.15 minus 1.20. That gives me 0.05. Now, 1.24 minus 1.20. That gives me 0.04. Yes. What is the ratio? 4:5. Yes. Able to follow. Till here, did he ever mention anything about the selling price? Till here, the question. Till this question, did he ever mention anything about the selling price? No. But he suddenly gave us the selling price and started talking about the gain percentage. Gain is nothing but profit. Profit percentage, I need to calculate the cost price to put it here as the combined average part. Now, after finding out the cost price, I put it here and go with the difference. That is the simple technique that we have. And then we calculate the ratio has to be 4:5. Bhargavi Reddy, we have to find CP. You told it well in advance. Beautiful. I appreciate your attempt. Sania gave the answer 4:5. Beautiful. Nice attempt. Now, guys, what is that you are supposed to do now? Take it down till the end of the screen and let me know when you are done. And how are you going to let me know? Drop a M and a A in the chat box, which means mission accomplished. What do we have here? The next question, please. How many kgs of sugar at rupees 50 paisa per kg must a man mix with 25 kgs of sugar at 34 paisa per kg so that by selling the mixture at 44 paisa per kg, he gains 10% on the outlay. 10% on the outlay. Okay. Now, it is a similar question as that in the previous question. Okay. similar question, but what has he given? Write down each one of them carefully. How many kgs of sugar? He is asking how many kgs of sugar. 8 rupees 50 paise per kg. This is price is given 50 paise per kg. 50 paise per kg. Okay. Next price, sugar. Next quantity, sugar with 25 kg of sugar. How much is the quantity given? 25 kg. Okay. At price 34 paise per kg. 34 paise per kg. So that the by selling the mixture at 44 paise per kg, selling price is what? Selling price is given again to us. SP is given as to be how much? 44 paise per kg. Now he gains 10% on the outlay. 10% is what? Gains 10% on the outlay, meaning he is gaining how much? 10%. 10% here. How do I need to do? I need to calculate CP. Can I go to a step directly here? Now can I write 44P is equals to 110%? Can I write it as to be 110 upon 100 of CP? Can I write it here directly? Yes. Now what will that give me? 0 goes away. Now this will give me 11 1 times, 11 4 times. So cost price will be how much, guys? It will be 40. And this 40, where do I have to place it? I have to place it here in the center, where I have to write my combined average. So difference gives me 40 and 10, 50, 10. Here, how much do I get? 6. What is the ratio in them? They must be mixed. They must be mixed in the ratio 3:5. But am I done with the answer? No. Am I done with the answer? No. Why? I need to calculate how many kg of sugar. Now ratio is given to us. To get to the actual value, what is that I need to do? I need to multiply it with the x, or I can directly go from 5. If the ratio is 5 here, I need to reach to 25. What is that I need to multiply here? 5. If I'm multiplying my right hand side with a 5, I also need to multiply my left hand with a 5. So 5 into 5 gives me 25 kgs, which I already have here. 5 into 3 gives me 15 kg. So how many kgs should be mixed? 15 kgs should be mixed. Or you can also look at it something like this. Ratio is given. Actual value will be 5x, which will be equals to 25. So x will be equals to 5. Now in place here, ratio will be 3x. So this 3 into x, in place of x you replace 5, you get a same answer 15. Yes, everybody, anyone, any problem with this question here? No, right? Can we move to the next question, guys? Yes or no, be quick. Yes, chalo, let's have the next question, please. What does the next question say? Okay, this question is for you, and you have less than 20 seconds to solve it, so jump on it. How much water be mixed in 36 liters of milk? The milk quantity is 36 liters. Okay. Worth rupees. Okay. I've overwritten it again. So I'll erase it here. 36 liter is visible now. 36 liter of milk worth rupees 5 a kg. Rupees 5 per liter. So that the value of the mixture is 3.60 per liter. Where should I write 3.60? I'll be writing it here. Now what about water? Water is a free entity. So how much will it cost me? 0 rupees per liter. Next step, what is that I need to do? I need to calculate the difference. So difference will be how much? 3.60 comes the way it is, and here I will get how much? 1.40. So the ratio will be how much? The ratio will be 114:36, which I can directly calculate 2 sevens, and I'll get 2 ones here, 8. 7:18. Yes. Fine. What is that he's asking now? Do we have any further question, or does it end here? How much water we mixed? Okay, 7:18 is the ratio that we have got. So I need to arrive at my actual quantity of water that I need to do. So I need to multiply with this 2. This gives me 36. Since I'm multiplying the RHS with 2, I need to also multiply my LHS with 2. That is 14. That is exactly what I had already got here. That is 36 and 14. I could have stopped here. Why? because the quantity already, the milk quantity is 36 and that of water should be 14. Directly I could have stopped here. Yes? Yes? The quantity is the same as the ratio, so I can directly calculate the water has to be, directly mention the water has to be 14. Yes? Fine. Let's go with the next question. Next question is also yours. Next question is also yours, guys. Come on. What does it say? How much sugar at rupees 9.5 a kg should be added to 17 kg of tea? There are two entities here. Two entities here. One is sugar. The other one is tea. Sugar and tea. How many kgs of sugar? So question mark. At 9.5 rupees per kg. 9.5 rupees per kg. Should be added to 17 kg of sugar. Quantity of sugar is given. Costing how much? Rupees 20 a kg. Rupees 20 per kg. Huh? So that the mixture be worth rupees. The mixture be worth rupees. I cannot see that. How much is that? 13 a kg. So that the mixture cost rupees 13 a kg. So where should I write this 13? I should write this 13 here in the center. 13. 13 rupees per kg. Next step is what? Simple difference. Difference is how much? Here 3.5. Here it is how much? 7. So what will be it? What will be it? 3.5 1 times, 3.5 2 times. So 1 is to 2. 1 is 2 is to 1. I'm sorry, 2 is to 1. In what ratio they must be mixed? They must be mixed in the ratio 2 is to 1. Okay? Class is comfortable. Can we have the next question, please? Okay, we need some space to solve this question. Meanwhile, you can take this whatever is on the screen. I'll give you less than 30 seconds, guys. You have to be very quick, okay? Very quick. When I say very quick, you have to be very quick. And we'll get back with the question that we have. Meanwhile, you can also try the question. It will be displayed on the screen. You can, those of you who are done taking it down, can try the question. And those of you who are still taking it down, you can take it down within 30 seconds. Okay, the question says, an alloy of copper and nickel contains 65% of copper. A second alloy contains copper and nickel in the ratio 17:3. In what ratio should the two alloys be mixed so that the new mixture contains 4 times as much as copper as nickel? 4 times as much copper as nickel. Okay, there are two alloys basically. So we'd like to start with two alloys here. I would call one alloy A1, the other alloy A2. Okay, next. The combined alloy, I'll call it as A dash, okay? What do they consist of? They consist of copper and nickel. All of them must have copper and nickel, okay? Copper and nickel. Next, an alloy of copper and, first statement, alloy of copper and nickel consist of 65% copper. So what is copper percentage here? 65%. If 65% in alloy 1 is copper, how much will nickel be? The remaining will be nickel. That is 35% of it will be nickel. Yes, 35% of it will be nickel. Next, the copper here is in the ratio 17:3. In alloy 2, it is in the ratio 17:3. Yes, next thing. In what ratio should the two alloys be mixed so that the new mixture contains 4 times as much as copper as nickel? If nickel is 1, copper will be how much? 4 times as much as of nickel. So it will be 4. 4:1. Now, every time, if you remember from the starting question, what did we do? We always dealt with one entity. Either rupees or percentage or anything. Now, here as well, I have to deal with either copper or nickel. But few of them are given in ratios. So what is that I need to do? I need to convert them into percentage. Now, I have copper here has to be 65%, which I will take it up directly. Next, alloy 2 is copper is in the ratio 17:3. So 17 parts out of total of, now we just learnt what is ratio. How do we go about it? 17 parts out of total of how many parts? 20 parts. Now, if I want to convert it into percentage, I need to multiply it with 100. 21 times 20, 5 times. 17 5s is 85%. What is it? 85% is copper. What about combined mixture here? Now you guys tell me what will be it. Four parts out of total of five parts. Four parts out of total of five parts will of 100. If I want to convert it into percentage, I need to multiply it with a 100. So this will go me how many times? 20 times. 4 into 2 is 4 into 20 is 80% is copper. Now 65% is given to me as to be in alloy 1. In alloy 2, how much? What is the percentage? 85%. The combined mixture should consist of how much? 80% of it. Now, what is the next step? Simple step, that is difference. Difference. What will I get here in difference? 80 minus 65. That gives me a 15 here. What about here? 5 here. In what ratio they must be mixed? In the ratio 1 is to 3. They must be mixed in the ratio 1 is to 3. The alloys must be, alloy 1 and alloy 2 must be mixed in the ratio 1 is to 3. Anybody, any problem with this? Few of them would be like, sir, let's deal with nickel. Yes, let's deal with nickel. What does nickel say? Let's go with nickel. Nickel, we have how much? First thing, in alloy 1, we have 35%. Next, in alloy 2, if 85% is copper, how much will be nickel? Nickel will be, my dear, it will be 15%. The combined average here, in combined part, the nickel should be how much? 20%. So deal with it. What will I have here? So how much will I have here? 15 here. Again, I'll have a 5 here difference. So what is the ratio? They must be mixed in the ratio 1 is to 3, which means that whatever I've got here is perfectly okay, which is the right answer. Chinmaya says, repeat it. Very interesting question. Chinmaya, thanks for asking. Just listen to it. What does it say? There is alloy 1, which consists of 65% of copper. 65% of copper. There is alloy 2, which consists of copper and nickel in the ratio 17 is to 3. Okay. In what ratio these two alloys must be mixed such that the combined mixture consists of 4 times as much as copper as nickel. 4 times as much as copper as nickel. So what did I do? Copper is 65% here. So here 17 is to 3. What do I have to do? I have to convert it into percentage to deal with percentage in all of them. So now 17 parts out of total of 17 plus 3, 20 parts will be what? Copper. If I want to convert it into percentage, I need to multiply it with 100. So that gives me copper has to be 85%. Here what will happen? Here 4 parts out of total of 5 parts is copper. If I want to convert it into percentage, I need to multiply it with 100. If I multiplying with 100, what do I get? I get it has to be 80%. Yes? Now, alloy 1 is 65, alloy 2 is 85. Combined mixture must consist 80% of copper. What am I dealing with in particular? I am dealing with all the copper terms. Now, the simple step that we do, difference, that gives me a ratio, 1 is to 3. Okay? Chalmaya? Chalmaya, are you okay? Tell me if you are okay. Please, you said repeated, I have repeated it for you. Yes, sir. Okay, fine. Okay, chalo. Let's go to the next question. What does it say? We already have the next question, huh? Okay. Okay, I'm solving two questions in one board. Okay, but still, let's get started. One alloy contains silver and copper in the ratio 5:1. Okay, an alloy consists silver and copper in the ratio 5:1. I will deal with it till a point and then I'll give it to you to solve it, and it will be a task for you. Okay, now one alloy contains silver and copper in the ratio 5:1. Here as well there are two alloys. So let me write it as to be alloy 1 and alloy 2. Okay, alloy 1 and alloy 2, and there will be a mixture to be made. Okay, alloy 1 has copper and silver and copper in the ratio. Silver is Ag, copper is Cu, in the ratio 5:1, in the ratio 5:1, and the other contains it in the ratio 7:2. Same, silver and copper in the ratio 7:2. What weights of the two must be melted together? What weights of these two alloys must be melted together so as to make a 5Lb mass? Do not worry about 5Lb mass. Let me take 5Lb is equals to 5 kg or whatever. We'll deal with it when it comes to it. Okay, till then. So as to make a 5Lb mass of 80% silver. Ag is how much? 80% here. What will be copper, guys? copper will be how much? 80% is silver, meaning 20% will be copper. Very good. Those of you who answered in the chat box, very good. Now, what is the ratio between copper and silver, silver and copper here? Percentage, percentage goes away. 21 times, 24 times. 4 is to 1 again, I've got here. 4 is to again, 1 again. I've got. Now, how many of you tended, how many of you went on to convert it into percentage? Wronged it. Why? If you see what will happen if I start converting, let me see the easy terms here. Copper is the easiest one. When compared to silver, copper appears to be easy. If I want to convert this into percentage, what will happen? One part out of total of six parts into 100, it goes into decimals, which will make my life difficult. Decimals make my life difficult. So I want to avoid decimals. So what do? I will deal with the fraction part only. And which one in particular? I see that silver is causing some trouble. So I'll go with copper. So copper is how much? One part out of total of six parts here. Here in alloy 2, copper is how much? Two parts out of total of nine parts. 7 plus 2, 9 parts. And copper here is how much? 1 part out of total of 4 plus 1, 5 parts. So where should I write 1 by 5? Dear, where should I write 1 by 5? In the combined average part, 1 upon 5. Now, what is that I need to do? If you remember, I always from the beginning told you that we have to calculate the difference, not subtraction. So greater minus smaller. That gives me how much? That gives me how much? 1 by 6 minus 1 by 5. That gives me 1 upon 30. 1 upon 30. What about here? I have 2 by 9 and 1 by 5. That gives me how much? 2 by 9 by 1 by minus 1 by 5 gives me 1 upon 45. 1 upon 45. I did simple subtraction, that is difference, to reach to these. So this will be how much? The ratio will be 30 is to 45. So is this the final ratio? No, I can still go with 15. That is 2 times and 15, 3 times. That gives me a ratio 2 is to 3. Now start thinking. What did he say? He said, I need a 5 Lb mass. In what ratio should alloy 1 and alloy 2 be mixed? Let me say 5 Lb is 5 kg here. 5 Lb is 5 kg. So 2 kgs of alloy 1 and 3 kgs of alloy 2 will give me how much? 5 kg or for that matter 5 Lb. 5 kg or 5 Lb. I could arrive at the answer directly because my ratios were equal to the quantities that was required. In what ratio they must be mixed? 2 kg and 3 kg. That gives me 5 Lb. Anybody any doubt with respect to whatever is done on the screen? Anybody any doubt? Now, what was the ratio that we had? We had it in the ratio 2 is to 3, right? If I'm not wrong, we had it in the ratio 2 is to 3. Okay. Alloy 1 and alloy 2 were in the ratio 2 is to 3. Now, if I want in particular the question that you have asked, if they ask for 8 Lb mass, for 8 Lb mass, what will be the quantity of alloy 1? Alloy 1 will be 2 parts out of total of 5 parts of 8 Lb. Yes. Now, 2 by 5 is nothing but what? 2 by 5 is nothing but what? 40%. Yes, 2 by 5 is nothing but what? 40%. Or I can also go with calculations. If this is 40% of, if this is 40% of 8 Lb, 10% is how much? 0.8. 40% will be 3.2. 0.8 into 4 times 3.2. If 3.2 is alloy 1, the remaining is what? 8 minus 3.2. That will give me 4.8. 4.8 will be the other alloy. If other than that, if this is other than that, mostly he will give you to form one which is the LCM of these two. So if it is 6 Lb mass, what will you do? 6 Lb mass, what will be it? 2 by 5. I mean, if it is 15 Lb, what will you do? 2 by 5 of 15. 5 ones, 5 threes, 3 into 2, 6. If one is 6, the other one will be how much? 4 and 5, 9. What does our next question say? A vessel is full of mixture of spirit and water in which there is 20% spirit. Okay, in which there is 20% spirit. Okay, let me draw a neat vessel for you. Okay, it has 20% spirit in it. How much is the spirit quantity? He says it is 20%. Okay. Spirit, what is it? A vessel is full of mixture of spirit and water. If spirit is 20%, what will be water? water will be 80%. I'll be discussing both the way to understand and the trick. Okay, I'll be discussing both, so stay connected. Okay, now a vessel consists of 20% spirit, a mixture of full of spirit and water, which is 20% spirit, so remaining will be 80% will be water. 5 liters is drawn off. 5 liters is drawn off. Okay, 5 liters is drawn off, and vessel is filled up with water. Vessel is filled up with water. What will be it? 5 liters water will come in now. Water is equals to 5 liters added now. Okay. If the spirit is now 12%, if the spirit is now 12%, find the total quantity in the vessel. What is he asking? Let me call T as to be the total quantity. Okay. Total quantity in the vessel he is asking. Okay. Now, I would like to write a relationship between spirit and total. And before that, I would like to explain you a simple concept. Okay. Let's say you and me are sharing a glass, okay? You and me, all the girls there, all the boys there, we are sharing a glass, okay? Now, what is that? The glass consists of, 20 ml of rasna in it, okay? Boys, 20 ml of rasna in it, okay? And the rest of it, 80% is, 80% is water, okay? 80% is water. I stir that glass. I stir whatever there is there in that glass. And I pour half of my content into your glass. Half of my content into your glass. Now, what will the percentage of, girls, what will be the percentage of rasna in your glass? What will be the percentage of rasna in your glass? I want everyone to answer, please. What will be the percentage of rasna in your glass? It will still remain 20%. It will still remain 20% itself. Percentage, I'm asking. If I have 20% rasna in my glass and 80% water, I stir it, pour half of it into your glass. So what will be the percentage of rasna in your glass? It will still be 20%. Boys will answer correctly. What will be the percentage of in your glass? It will be 20%. Gayatri Reddy answered it perfectly. It will still be 20%. So start thinking now. Start thinking now. These 5 liters which were drawn out of this vessel, these 5 liters which were drawn out of this vessel will consist of how much, what will be the percentage of spirit in this? It will still remain 20%. Yes or no? It will still remain 20%. Yes? Now, let me write the equation, okay? Let me write the equation. What is the total? Okay. What is the percentage of spirit in total? It is 20% of total. 20% of total. Do you agree? Next. What is happening? 5 liters is removed. Upon removing spirit, I'm talking in terms of spirit now. What is spirit? 20% of total initially. Now, I'm removing how much? 5 liters. How much spirit am I losing? 20% of 5 liters I'm losing. Why? Because this 5 liters will also have 20% spirit in it. Yes, do you agree? Now, let's move ahead. Now, upon in this total side, there will be total T. Minus 5 liters, these are the minus 5 liters, plus 5 liters was added. This is just total, minus 5 liter, plus 5 liter. So the quantity doesn't change, it remains the same. The total remains total because 5 liters was removed and 5 liters was added. Now, what does the question say? If the spirit is now 12%, upon what? Upon these transactions, that is 5 liters was drawn off and 5 liters was added, what happened to the spirit? Spirit now is 12%. 12% meaning, can I write it as 12/100? This should be equals to 12/100. Yes or no? Yes or no? This should be equals to 12/100. Now what will I do? I'll have to cross multiply. So this gives me what? 100 into 20% of T minus 20% of 5 liters is equals to 12T. Now, if I multiply this 100 inside, will this percentage go away? This percentage and this. So what will I be remaining with? 20T minus 20 into 5 gives me how much? 100. 100L is equals to 12T. 12T. Now, you might have calculated the answer already. What is that? If I send this 12 onto this side and 100 onto that side, I will be remaining with 8T is equals to 100. So, T will be equals to how much? T will be equals to how much, guys? 12.5 liters. It will be equals to 12.5 liters. Now, This one was for purely understanding. That this one was, this entire thing was for purely understanding. So what is that we need to do? What is that we need to do? Listen carefully. Listen carefully. Now, what happened? Let me have the question, please. What happened to the spirit? What happened to the spirit? 20%, okay, the weather is full of mixture of spirit and water, in which there is 20% spirit, okay. 5 liters of drawn off. On removing 5 liters, on removing 5 liters, the amount of spirit, the amount of spirit dropped from where to where? From 20 to 12%. From 20% to 12%. So it changed from 20% to 12%. So how much did he lose? On removal of 5 liters, how much spirit was lost? 8% of spirit was lost. Yes, 8% of spirit was lost. Yes, from 20 to 12, 8% of spirit was lost. Yes. So now, what should I do? In the total, how much is? In the total, if the total is T, 20% will be how much? So what do I need to do? Calculate it. Cross multiply and calculate it. That gives me how much percentage. Percentage, I'll write it away. So AT is equals to 20 into 5, that is 100 again. Total will be equals to 12.5 liters. Total will be equals to 12.5 liters. Yes, everyone able to follow? Anybody any doubt? With this, I would like to bring this session to an end. You've been a wonderful, wonderful class. Thank you so much. I appreciate your time and patience. Hope to see you soon. Praveen Jadhav.